in the Bible, Jesus used parables many times to convey deep spiritual truths. Approximately six of those he used about planting, growing a garden, what a farmer would do. And you say, well, we're not farmers. Yes, you are. You say, well, how is that? Because you're planting seeds in your life, in your career, and those around you, in your church. So we're all planting something. And so therefore, these spiritual truths are incredible to help us to learn how to live the life that God wants us to have. Now, right now, people are starting their fall gardens, and I've told Max to make sure he plants me some spinach. Nothing quite like fresh spinach. It's almost like air. It's wonderful. But see, a lot of people didn't plant over the last 2 years because of COVID. They were kind of staying in. And so now a lot of the ground has gotten hard, and weeds have taken over, and so you've got to do some work with that before you can start planting. And so we're going to learn a lot about how to plant seeds well in our lives today. In Mark chapter 4, verse 26, the kingdom of God is like this. Someone plants some seed in the ground, then during both the day and night, whether that person is awake or asleep, the seed is growing silently. Notice, while you're doing other things, what is planted is growing further. Now, the person who planted the seed can't see how it's growing because it's hidden under the ground. But in darkness, the soil is helping the seed to grow. First, the plant sprouts through. Then the tender stalks appear. Then the stalk puts on buds. And finally, the full head of grain or fruit appears. Then, when it is ready and ripe, the farmer cuts it, because it's harvest time. So a few things that we can learn from this. God expects my life and my church to grow. Growth is an evidence of being alive. Growth is also an evidence of being healthy. Just like your kids, you know. Do you have to tell your kids or grandkids, grow? No, if they're healthy, they're fed, they just grow. And if they're boys, they eat you out of house and everything, don't they? I remember when I was 18, I could eat a whole large pizza and say, that's a nice appetizer. Can't do that anymore, but okay, got one or two, okay, I'm stuffed. But back then, you couldn't fill me up because I was growing. And back then, I couldn't put on any weight. You know, now I've got to watch it. So it's naturally healthy grows. And so therefore, your spiritual life, if it's healthy and so forth, it grows as well. So the question is, spiritually, are you growing spiritually or superficially? Oh, you can memorize volumes of verses in the Bible. You can attend all the classes you want. You can be here every time I preach. But that doesn't mean you're growing spiritually. That could be superficially. It's how you're living your life, how you're treating people, how you're conducting things in life. You know, anytime on a farm, the human farmer wants to plant something. Like if he plants corn, he expects that. Soybeans, expect those to come up. Cotton, or of course spinach, you plant, you expect that to come up. So what are you getting in your life? Are you getting good stuff coming out after you've planted, or is bad stuff? It all depends on the seeds you planted. Because what you plant is coming back to you. Amen. Second, any fruit in my life, good or bad, comes from seeds planted by people. So it's important to understand that not just you plant in your life, but other people plant in your life. Who you listen to, who you study under, where you're getting your information from, that's planting seeds in your life. It includes coworkers. So who are you allowing to plant in your life? Some people let the television plant in their life all the time. You know, and it's not always good. Now, some things are good, like the Astros winning, you know, going to the World Series, that's great. I've always been an Astros fan. But some things that plants are not good. That frankly, there's some shows I just don't watch. It's amazing. People say, well, it's on there, so I had to watch. No, you don't. You can change the channel. Or you can turn it off and go for a walk. So you've got to watch who is planting in your life, because those seeds are coming. And seeds are ideas. They're convictions. They're beliefs. They're incentives. They're habits. And you plant these in your life, and then they come back. You know, where did that come from? You planted it in. Now it's coming up to fruition. You can plant relational needs in your life. You know, if you have relational needs, you need to plant relationships in your life. You know, if you want to have friends, you got to be friendly. You know, it's somebody said, well, I don't have any friends. Well, have you been friendly to other people? You know, it works both ways, doesn't it? Now, what about your character? What are you planting good things in your character? Like, you know, learning, growing, and being around mentors who will encourage you. 3, we often can't see the seeds growing in our life. Realize whether they're good or bad, other people notice the seeds growing. Do you realize that? You may not be aware of it at times, but other people are. And growth usually happens, you realize, in dark times. You know, when the seed is in the soil, it's growing, but you don't even know it's growing. And sometimes we're in a low time and we think, well, nothing's happening in my life. But God is working right then in your life. Back in Mark 4, it says the person that planted the seed can't see how it's growing because it's hidden under the ground. In darkness, the soil is helping the seed to grow. So you don't just need sunlight. You also need water and nutrients from the soil to grow. And sometimes you need darkness. And sometimes the greatest spiritual growth in our lives doesn't happen on the mountaintops. Everything's going great. No, it's when we have to grind down low and say, what is real in my life? How can I trust God to get out of the situation? So God is doing a lot of work. Now, 4. Growth in my life is slow and gradual and happens in stages. See, that's the opposite of what we want. We want it fast, glorious, and everything on the top. And God says, I'm not in a hurry. Back in Mark, it says, first it sprouts and then it gets the stalk, then it adds the bud, then the bud turns to flower, and then you get the fruit. See, it takes time. I can't tell you how many people want to find a certain verse where they'll be instantly spiritual. You know, take a certain class, it'll make them spiritually mature right away. No, it doesn't. In fact, if you do that, believe me, it'll just dry right up because the roots aren't deep into the spiritual life you need. I've had countless people wanting to do various things in the life of the church. No, where are your roots? Are you deep in God's word, or is it just superficial knowledge? Growth takes 4 things. T-I-M-E, time. It takes time to go through life's difficulties. It takes time to really grow. You know, I look back in my life and I can see how God has used the low points in my life to get me where I am now and doing well. One of the most frustrating things about us, though, is we're in a hurry and God's never in a hurry. You know, you try to pray, God, come on, let's speed it up. God says, well, so what's time to God? In Philippians 1:6, but know this, being confident in it, he who began a good work within you will continue his work until it's finally finished on that day when Christ Jesus comes back again. Now, you know when it's going to be finally finished? When either the rapture occurs or you get to heaven. So when somebody says, I've got it all together, they need to go back to first base. They might need to go back to home and start all over again. I mean, they struck out. Because we are a continual work in progress. It's never on the back, and we can always learn from each other.